till the dry bones respond, I gotta run over. Till cancer responds, I gotta run over. Till my family responds, I gotta run over. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up till I overflow. Come on. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Say, fill me up till I overflow. I wanna run. Oh, I wanna run over.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What do you need to be? What do you need today?
Hallelujah.
You say, we say, fill me up. We already know we're full of the Spirit of the Lord. All we got to do is let it overflow and run over. Amen. Remember that we're already filled. What else do you need? Fill me with your strength. Fill me with your joy. Fill me with your manifested glory, Lord. Hallelujah.
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 Fill me up.
Yes, hallelujah.
Until I overflow. How many people want to be filled up?
Hallelujah.
I want to fill me up until I overflow. Because if he overflows me, I can be a blessing, be a blessing. Sometimes of us say, we don't want to go out to fill us up. That means we don't want to bless nobody else. So what you doing then?
Right.
What you doing? I want God to keep increasing me and overflowing me so I can be blessed to be a blessing. Because the more you be a blessing, people can see that on the outside. They can say, you know what? I want what's on them, so I'm going to come to church.
Hallelujah.
Because there's nothing overflowing in you. Why would they want to come to church?
Hallelujah.
So I want them to overflow in every area of my life.
Amen.
My life is spiritually, financially, as far as how I do with my children. I want the Lord to bless me in all the areas of my life. In my health, when the doctors say they come go wrong, look what the Lord did to me overflowing in my life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Overflowing.
Yes.
Overflowing.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Well, welcome to IAM Church. Amen. Welcome.
Amen.
Where Jesus Christ is what?
Lord.
Where Jesus Christ is?
Lord.
And is he the center of your joy?
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
He's the center of your joy. Amen. Amen. Can't make it without him. Amen. Well, welcome to IAM Church, where Jesus Christ is Lord. Well, how many people know here online or in the house that we are a church that's what? We are a church of what?
We're not just a church.
We are a family.
Don't
I threw you off. Yes. I got to throw you off. I got to make you think. Amen. If you ain't thinking, you ain't going nowhere.
You're
thinking. Amen. We are not just a church. We are a family. Amen.
Yes.
Where we do ministry and
life together.
For we walk by
faith
and not by
sight.
Amen, amen, amen. So we like to say welcome to the in-house members. You can go and be seated. Welcome to the in-house members and also the online audience. We say say welcome to what we have going on today, where Jesus Christ is Lord and he is doing some awesome things. Amen. So go ahead and we now have it on our church page. Go ahead and share the video of what's going on today. Go let your family and friends know. Share it to some of your friends. Share at least the four or five friends and family. Go ahead and share it to them. Let them know what's going on. Amen. Yeah, share it to a few of your friends. Let them know what's going on in the house, amen, so they can be a part of what you're getting in the house, amen. Or if you have somebody, you can do a watch party, a share party. Let them know, you know, hey, come and check my pastors out. See what's going on. And today we have a special guest, amen. Special to some of y'all, but anointing to me. I want the overflow that comes on him. I want the overflow. Anointing, whatever you want to call it. But how that saying go? Where you get the, what was that? Whose beard was that came on? I want some of that Aaron's beard on me. I want some of the gray anointing. I want some of the glasses anointing. I want the prosperity anointing. I want the healing anointing. I want the apostolic anointing. I want all the anointing that this man got on his life, on my life. Amen. I want it. I want it all. Because if I get it, Pastor Noel get it, guess what? We can go to the y'all next.
Hallelujah.
So if he's receiving it, we want it all. I want it all. I mean, how many people say, I want it all? I want it all. Amen, amen. Amen. So go ahead and share to your friends and family so we can get them a part of what's going on in I Am Church. Amen. Amen. Our theme this year is what? Faith to possess the double, to live out the hundredfold. Faith to possess the double, to live out the hundredfold. Amen. How are we going to do it? We're going to do that spiritually, financially, and physically, because we are living the dream for 2021. How many people saying we've been living the dream this year? But how many people know we've been attacked while we've been building too? Lord Jesus. Hey, sometimes when you're ready to go from faith to faith, glory to glory, things are going to start happening in your life. But if you start adding on to your faith, think about what your faith statement is. God says, I'm going to move you from faith to faith and glory to glory, and just watch God work. Man, so some things that's been going on, everyone see as you walked in this morning, see some new upgrades again, amen? You see how the foyer looked, you see the cafe look, the cafe's been updated and cleaned up, and so our next goal is to do the children's rooms next week, so to keep donating and sowing into those, because if we look good, the world can see what we're doing, amen? That we are putting finances into what we're doing here in the ministry. We got the sound, we got the video. Now we're going to be updating some stuff with the keyboards. We're updating some drums here. So because God says he's going to bring us some people, amen. He's going to bring us a full band. So we got to get it all situated and set up for them, amen. Right now that's the basic keyboard. I want to get an updated keyboard. I mean, we got some basic drums, but I want updated drums, amen. So God's about to do it, and then we get the praise team. The praise team is going to be coming forth, amen. We're just getting some things together right now. Amen. God's going to bring us an awesome praise and worship team, amen. So if you'd like to be a part of that, let us know and send us a text, amen, and we'll get you a part of when they're practicing and what's going on, amen. Amen. How many people seen? I sent some links out this morning. We're up doing a lot of upgrades here in the ministry. I sent some links out this morning about the praise and worship and also about the announcements. All you got to do is look at your text messages. You can see some links on what's going on in the ministry. We're doing some things where sometimes you don't get a chance to get here for the announcements and stuff, but we sent you some links this morning where you can click the link. You can see all the announcements. Also, you can click on what's going on in praise and worship. So if you like to click on those links, you can see what's going on here in the ministry. You can do that. Don't forget about morning manna. Monday morning manna with Ms. Janae Mano on Monday mornings at 10 a.m. Also, Monday night intercessory prayer. Monday night intercessory prayer, that's on Mondays at 7:30 on Monday nights. Then also DTI training. Don't forget, we're going to resume that in January for our DTI and MTI trainings because of everything that's been going on. So we're going to resume that in January. The week we want to do that things in decency and order to make sure that's done correctly. Amen. Don't forget about Wednesday night Bible study. We're teaching on faith. Amen. The ABCs of faith. Amen. So right now we're on our third week. So go ahead and be a part of that. We've been seeing a lot of people have been responding. A lot of people have been getting a lot of awesome testimonies on that. So you keep flooding that. Amen. And don't forget about after service, don't forget to support the IAM Nutrition and the cafe in there. So we're doing some other things to get some things built up in there, amen. So go on and support those. How many people like the decorations? Amen, amen. If you haven't got a chance, go to the bathrooms, see what they're doing in the bathrooms. Pastor Noel's been working on her team of people. She's doing some things in the bathroom. She got the cafe together. She's doing the bathrooms next. Then from there, we're going to be doing the bookstore and the gift shops. We're working on those two also. So go ahead and be prepared for that.
I was going to say, he didn't say the boardroom, too.
Oh, the boardroom, too, yeah.
The boardroom is like, what did we name it yesterday? Kingdom Excellence.
Kingdom Excellence, amen.
Kingdom Excellence.
Amen. That's our boardroom where we're going to be doing million-dollar deals sooner or later. Amen. We're gonna be doing millions. When we meet and negotiate with people, we're gonna be going in there and doing million-dollar deals. Amen. So that's what we proclaiming to God. That's what we're wanting in that boardroom. What we're gonna be doing. So we gotta have a standard in there. Amen. 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 So next week, everyone says next week. We want to encourage everyone to wear pink because we're gonna be celebrating Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So if you like to wear pink, go and wear pink. We're gonna be celebrating Breast Cancer Awareness Month. On October 31st, we're not gonna be having a Hallelujah Night, but we are gonna have some bags and some gifts and candy and stuff. So we encourage everyone the next few weeks to bring some candy and some get with Pastor Gloria, but bring some candy and all that. So we're going to give the kids on that Sunday a gift from the church. Amen. So if you'd like to be a part of that, if you don't like to go out and get candy, just put on your envelope Hallelujah Night, or just put October 31st on your envelope so we can go purchase the candies and stuff for you. Amen. And on Thursday, because a lot of things have been going on in the last few months, so I call different people to partner with on different things here in the ministry. So on Thanksgiving, we're partnered with a gentleman. His name is Coach Jackson. He's one of my friends. He's going to be doing a Thanksgiving, giving out turkeys, and also we're going to be partnering. We're going to be doing some things too. But on Thanksgiving, on November the 14th, we're going to have it at church here. We're going to have people come in here to go to church first, and then we're going to be serving them some food and also giving away turkeys and dinners and stuff. So we put that on your calendar on November 14th. If you'd like to start going and giving towards that, you can put it on an envelope. Thanksgiving, we're going to be starting to partner with. We're going to be partnering with Jackson Family Services in regards for Thanksgiving to serve the community that we serve and outside the community. So if you'd like to be a part of that, get with Pastor Noel and she will get you plugged in on how we can make that happen. Also for Christmas dinner, we're partnering also with someone for the Christmas dinner. We're going to have a nice Christmas dinner. We're going to have it at a nice hotel. We're partnering with a church called the Message Church. That's my Aunt Deborah and Pastor Bishop Rick Garrett. We're partnering with them to have a nice Christmas dinner. So we're coming with them, and they're coming with us, and we're going to have a nice Christmas dinner because we just have a lot going on in the last couple of months, and you mean just a lot of stuff going on. So we're just partnering with other ministries now that has integrity. We partner with other ministries that have integrity. You can't partner with everybody. You can't partner with everybody. So we're partnering with them for the Christmas dinner. And so that's one of the things we're doing. So, and then from there, we're going to be getting with everyone for the new year. But don't forget the Wear the Pink, the Hallelujah Night for the candy and stuff, Thanksgiving, November 14th. Then the Christmas dinner, we partner with the Message Church. And that date is going to be on December 18th. So you put that on there, December 18th at 5 p.m., and it's going to be held at the Holiday Inn Suites. The ticket's going to be $58 per adult, but you get the dinner, you'll get the dance, you get everything included with that. But we'll send you more information as we're going. Let us know you're interested so you get your tickets. Right now we have 10, how many tickets we have right now? We have 10 tickets, so please, if you'd like to be interested, let us know you'd be the one like to be the first ones to attend that. Amen? Amen. You have anything else, babe?
Nope.
All right. What we're going to do then, we're going to, what is it? Nothing. Oh, you brought the microphone up. So.
Yeah, I changed my mind. Well, no, I didn't. Well, y'all know I'll be getting, come on now, don't even play me like that. Y'all know I'll be excited when the apostle and our lady be in the house. Y'all know I'll be excited because they be here.
That's right.
Number one, okay, I'm going to tell you it's twofold.
Come up in here. Our leadership is in here. So I'm excited because I want them to see what's going on at IAM, to see that they didn't labor in vain. Because they labored for 40-something years pastoring this church, and now they trusted us with it. And God had them trust us with it. So we want them to know that the vision is still alive. That the vision is still alive. Shoot, that's all I'm saying. I'm just excited. Y'all woke? Ain't we excited in what God is doing for all of us in all of our lives? Not just the church, in our lives. Yeah, we've been hit hard. Yeah, the enemy's trying to come after us, but that's only because we're in purpose. That's because we are fulfilling the vision of this house. So, of course, he's going to try to hit us and knock us down, but the devil is a lie. We shall go forth. We shall build still. And grow. All right, that's it. All right. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm done.
So without further ado, go ahead and stand. I'm going to bring forth my father, my apostle, my mentor, all the above, Apostle Alfred Craig Sr.
Praise the Lord. I guess I might as well just join the church, become a member now. Y'all done. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. You can be seated in God's presence today. But, you know, I've been here for the last 3 weeks, huh?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Praise God. And but this time we flew because we've been driving the last two times. I said, I don't feel like driving again. But see, this is our normal time we come on a third Sunday. And so I said, well, no, we got to stay on target. And so we flew in early this morning, praise God, and flying back out tonight. Amen. No, we come on Friday, stay until Monday. I said, no, we're going to fly in. They said, blow in, blow up, and blow out. But it's exciting. Each week, we've been seeing progress. Yeah. You know, man, we actually came in the first time when it was like machines and things in here. That's all in the machines. And so then, like I said, it came back again and back again. So that when you can see what God is doing, amen? And then the whole thing is now is that, you know, y'all are on target. And like Pastor Alfred was saying there, Elijah asked for something, didn't he? Elisha. Elijah said, you know, what would you like for me to give? Ask anything. He asked for boldness, didn't he? He said, what I want is a double portion of what's on you. And, you know, that's available because, you know, mantles are on the earth. They're given by God. But, you know, when a person wants those kind of mantles and they're willing to do what it takes to get them, it will come. And y'all are on track for it right now. I said, y'all are on track right now for it right now. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Because exactly what we did, we started back in 1993, and we came back. We had about 50 members. That's all we had. Pastor Gloria, when you were part of our church back in 1993, 94, you came in sometime around that time. I know you've been around for a long time. Amen. But you saw the growth. And so we actually started off in a little bit of small building, smaller than this. It was smaller than this. But that mantle was on me from Apostle Price, from Apostle Fred Price. And I knew without a shadow of a doubt that we were on our way to thousands of people, you know, around the world. And so I remember that first year that we were here, I think we got to about 100 people after that first year. And then we went to about 200, then 500, then 1,000. Then we started establishing other churches throughout the city and things like that, actually throughout the state. Because we had one in Tempe, one in Mesa, South Phoenix, Chandler, Scottsdale, Gilbert, amen, Coolidge, Casa Grande, Tucson. And so we were just hacking churches off. And all the people, those pastors still going, well, some of them have passed away and things like that, but God still does great things. So when God wanted me to start this apostolic ministry, you know what I mean? I was saying, God, if you want me to start apostolic ministry, what about the pastoral ministry? Because God would never leave sheep alone. And then all of a sudden, the burning bush came. Pastor Alan Noel, are you following? And I knew without a shadow of a doubt that it was, well, I know Gloria, over here, Gloria. Johnson, the other Gloria. Yeah, you've been with us since the beginning. 95? No, before 90. You was at the small church. Ain't that right? So you had to be here by 1991, something like that. You was a small church. Because we used to go to her house and eat. Yes. And Gloria would just fix us food and things like that all the time. So that's why I remember Gloria. I know, you've been here. You've been here almost 30 years then. Pretty close to 30 years. Amen. So we got gray together. Yeah, we got gray. Amen. We got gray together. And so she's been around for a long time too. So what I'm saying is God, when I see this happening, like I said, y'all are right on target. As a matter of fact, far as church-wise, length-wise, y'all are actually doing in front of us right now. Because the church we had was not even this large. And we sure didn't have no cafeteria and all the other stuff y'all got out there. Amen. We had people all in the hallways and stuff. So what is, once the anointing drops on this place, you just got to be ready for it. Because all of a sudden people just start coming in, and you were saying, I didn't even invite them. How did they get here? Well, they heard about it. It's like the wind of the Holy Ghost start blowing people in this place, amen? And you just got to be ready. I remember sometimes my urge was saying, man, what are we going to do? I don't know. That's what you got to be prepared because, amen, they just start coming in, praise God. Our teachers, we had over 250 kids. So y'all teach got to get ready too. And sometimes I would meet a pastor that was down the street from us, And we'd be in the restaurant. He said, Pastor, I'm so glad your church overflowing. I said, how come? He said, because sometimes when the parents go to y'all's church and they ain't got enough room for their kids, they come down to our church.
Amen.
So we can overflow from y'all's family. Amen. Praise God. So we laugh about that. But you know what? The whole thing is you just got to be ready. You gotta be, that's why when Pastor Al talking about the DTI training, you know, the training, you just got to be ready. You don't go to Vietnam or wherever the wars are and learn how to fight. You better learn something before. Is that right, Pat? You better learn before you get over there. Is that right? So you don't train once you get there. You want to get ready for that because it's coming. I'm saying again, it's coming. How many believe it's coming?
Amen.
Amen. It's on you. Praise God. It's on you. Amen. And so see that like this church building thing he got. See that's a part of the anointing he got on me too because that's all we've done. Ever since he was a kid, we just built churches. And, you know, sometimes churches be half done. We come in, y'all come on in anyway. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Sometimes we got things dug up over there. Amen. And one time we had to enlarge the church because of the bathrooms. Because we got that building on 51st Avenue and Thomas, 25,000 square feet building. But we only got, we sectioned half of it off. And so we had to get all new bathrooms and things like that. So then when we had to open up the whole thing up, the city made us dig all those bathrooms about a year later, all because of the thing that you have to pass the city with, the codes that changed. We had to redig up all those bathrooms, put new pipelines in there, and building is something else. But you know what? Like I said, he learned that, and that's on him already. That church building is already there. Look at all this stuff that happened. He had no experience, but he'd been a part of it. Alfred did everything but preach. So he can do everything from there on, but it took a few years for him to come up here.
Amen.
So everything from there on he done.
Thank God.
Amen. So y'all got a pastor and then his blessed wife Noel.
Amen.
Yes. That is his gift from the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord know he needed a helpmate. That's strong. He didn't need no weak woman to let him do anything he wanted. He needed a woman that could do this right here.
Right.
You know, and do this right here. That's what he needed that. So God gave him one of those.
Amen.
And, but she's a blessing.
Thank you.
Is she a blessing, y'all?
Yes.
She's a blessing. Amen.
Thank
Praise
you.
God. And of course, myself, Dr. Bell, you know, like I said, Dr. Bell with me, she's been ever since we started. Amen. A lot of times people didn't know, but she's been to every class I've been to, she's been to the same classes. And that is from Rhema Bible Training Center to Kenneth Hagin to Apostle Price to we had some special training by John Maxwell. Everything I've been through, she's been through the same thing.
Amen.
And so that's a good thing, too, as time goes on. You know, you ought to begin to squeeze some of that information out of her, too, because it's in there. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. And but you don't want Dr. Bill if you ain't ready for no truth, though.
Right.
If you ain't ready for the truth, she's the wrong one. You know what I mean? But we just want a pastor's wife. No, you know, she ain't got no big old hat on. You know, you better watch out, you know. So, but you know what? She's a new kind. It's the real thing. Because sometimes people put these things on pastor's wives. You're supposed to be in some corner and just shut up and don't say nothing. Well, that's over with now.
Yes, it is.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. But the Lord is good. Amen. He's good. Now, so again, thank you all so much for welcoming me. Like I said, you know, I wasn't coming, but then, man, after talking about it earlier, I said, you know what? This is my regular Sunday. I want to stay on target for my being here regular.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And so y'all might not see me again unless the Lord said the same for a whole nother month. Amen. But it's been a blessing.
Yes.
It's been a tremendous blessing. Praise God. Okay, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we honor you today. We give you thanks for your goodness and your love. We thank you as always, precious Father, for your divine presence and your Holy Spirit. You've given unto us that he is our guide and teacher. We ask also, Father, that spiritual wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and skill is given to us, which enables and equips us with supernatural power and anointing to minister your word effectively as we ought. We ask that every ear is anointed to hear, every eye is anointed to see, and every heart is anointed to believe and to receive the things of the Spirit of God. Father, we covenant with you in advance for all the things that you shall accomplish in this church today to give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor for it. In Jesus' name, everybody say it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, I was on my way back the other week to Las Vegas, back home, and the Lord put something in my heart, and that is because where y'all are headed, where y'all are right now and going up, I don't want to keep where you're headed because that keeps us to in the future. But where y'all are right now to where you're going. Are you following? One thing God put in my heart, you know, one of the main things that stops dreams is not the absence of a dream, but it's the ability to finance that dream. How many of you really had, how many of you know if you had the money that you to really do what's really in your heart? I mean, that was, man, you could do so much more. Yeah. Yeah. What's in your heart? Now, you know, I mean, that thing is in your heart. Yeah. You know what I mean? Those areas. And I know that, as I said, when we came back in 1993, after being under Apostle Price, I saw multi-million dollar ministry. I saw thousands of members. And I had a vision to want to get there. But I had no money to get there. Are y'all following me? And so the Lord put in my heart to start helping people to learn how to believe him supernaturally. Because where y'all are going, whether you're in your business or whether it's personal or whether it's in the ministry, there is a natural progression of finances that will happen automatically. You know, you're doing your savings, kind of thing like that. But there's also in the kingdom of God where the Holy Ghost comes on you, like he did Mary. And Mary said, but how shall these things be? Seeing I know not a man, he said, the Holy Ghost come upon you. There are certain things that God's going to do in your life that you're not going to be able to accomplish in the natural realm, even though hard work. And we should do hard work. Yeah, right. Bouts of man, no work can't eat. Yeah. But there's another side of it that God put in my heart that I had to learn as pastoring. There's a super, just like Jesus was supernatural. You know, he was not naturally born. Mary had to go through some process, but he was not naturally born. So some things that God wants to do in your life that you're never going to accomplish, you know, putting $10 a month in the bank. But yet, it's not the Roman savings. But there's some things that God wants to do in your life that is Ephesians 3:20, exceeding abundantly and above all you can ask or think according to the power working. That's what the angel told Mary, wasn't it? He said, the power of the highest is going to come on you. Yeah. And that which shall be coming you is going to be with the Holy Ghost. So there's some things in our lives, and I believe that because of the anointing that's on this ministry, there's some things that God's speaking to Pastor Allen Noel about, you know, especially as they're following in our footsteps and beyond. Because the Bible said he's going to do even better. The Bible said, Jesus said, the works that I do, he's going to do and greater works than he should do. Amen. That understanding my revelation of prosperity. You know, not just to buy a car. Right. We say cash, clothes, and a car. Ain't nothing wrong with none of that. Thank God for all three of those. But it goes beyond that. That's basic. But to get the kingdom of God financed at the level that God wants it to be financed. To get your ministry financed at the level God wants it to be financed. Are you following? In those areas, there's a supernatural side of it. That, I learned from Apostle Price and them. And God put in my heart to begin to start sharing some of those things in that area. We were in ministry school, and Apostle Fred Price was there. He's the president. And so we were asking him questions. You know, he had to learn, you know, had a student, you know, to the president ask a question. So one of the students asked him, said, Dr. Price, at that time he was Dr. Price, says, can you, you know, says, you know, we as students are struggling. All of us was. And we know that this is a blessed ministry. It was. You know what I mean? He built a 10,000-seat auditorium paid for on the day of dedication. I think like $15 million. This is back in 1991, something like that. We are here students. How are we going to, we want to be able to pay our tuition, but we don't have the money. And since it's such a blessed ministry, do you all have any kind of special programs that we can get a part of? And so Apostle Price's response was what we was not looking for. As a matter of fact, his response made me glad that I'm not the one to answer the question. He said that the Lord tell you to come to school? Well, you would get real spiritual then. Oh, yes, the Lord spoke to me about coming to this ministry school. He said this. And this is what kind of got all of us kind of, you know, startled us. He said, you mean to tell me God told you to come to this school and not paying your tuition? Mm-hmm. Now, at first you can get upset because this man is being hard on us. He's not being sensitive. But then I thought about that. There was two classes we had during that time. Number one was faith. He was teaching us on faith. I sit right in front of him like this far. teaching us on faith, what faith is, why we need faith, how to you know, release your faith. And he taught us line upon line on that. And another class he was teaching, Pastor Allen then teaching another class at the same time called the Blood Covenant. Those two classes we've been teaching, and so rather than me getting upset by what he said, I thought about those classes. I'm learning faith. And faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And with faith, all things are possible. And then the Blood Covenant was teaching that if you are in covenant with God, he is obligated because of your covenant with him to meet your need. So Dr. Price was teaching from a covenant perspective. He wasn't teaching from a religious perspective. You know, religious folks are trying to find somebody, you know, some type of program. Nothing wrong with programs. Nothing wrong with that. But sometimes we limit God to programs.
That's right.
But he makes that statement. You mean God told you to come and is not paying your tuition? Mm-hmm. Now this is the thing, for instance. If, Pastor, say for instance, I just met Pastor Cedric. And he don't know nothing about me. But Pastor Cedric understands a word called blood covenant because he's from Africa. He understands blood covenant. He's been trained up in blood covenant. And he understands that if you say something that we come to covenant together, I can be a billionaire and you can be broke. But now, once you come to covenant, you're now a billionaire.
Amen.
And whatever you ask in my name, you can have it because we're in covenant together. He understands that. So the first week, I talked to him from a non-covenant perspective. I says, Pastor Cedric, now there is a Rolls Royce dealership over there in Scottsdale. Meet me there at 2 o'clock a day, and I'm going to pay cash for your Rolls Royce. Pastor Cedric, he's going to say, I don't know y'all. Why is he going to say that? Because he'll have no idea about me. There's nothing he knows. Is that right? But if I, on his way out, he kind of walking slow, too. And I can tell he's in kind of hoping that he will, but afraid that he won't type faith.
Amen.
But if I say, hold on, Pastor Cedric, come here for a moment. Get this knife and let's cut covenant. Pastor Cedric's eyes get big because he knows what I'm doing now. That not only am I giving my word, but I'm putting a covenant behind my word. That if I break my word, I myself will self-destruct. I will die. That's what God was saying. God says, I couldn't find nobody greater to swear by, so I swore by myself. You know, people sometimes say, I swear by my mama's grave. What they're trying to do is tell you that you know I ain't lying. So God says, when I make covenant with you, I swear by my own self, that I'm going to be faithful to my covenant. So now let me ask you something. Once I did that, and Pastor Cedric understanding the revelation of blood covenant, is he still walking slow?
Right.
No, he ain't walking slow. Is that right? He's speeding up now, ain't he? Are you following me? Why? Now, all I did was did one thing, is I entered into a blood covenant with him, which he understood. And he knew that he was just not following my word, but what I had now put behind my word that gave him assurance that I was going to do what I did because of what I was waiting to put behind it. And see, so when you understand that about a blood covenant, that you are in a blood covenant with God, your faith goes to a whole nother level. Because it's not no longer on based upon your works now. It's based upon what Jesus did. He entered into a blood. Like we're talking about the communion today. But we recognize what the communion really is and the revelation of it. And I take it. God got to heal me. God got to meet my needs. And now Jesus said, this is the blood of my new covenant, which I'm shedding for you. Are y'all found said today?
Yes.
See, so that confidence, and see, that's why I began to understand, because Dr. Price and they were so bold. They were the arrogant. I said, man, how God blessed me. They're so bold and arrogant. They knew who they were. Because that confidence in the word of God. So when they opened that Bible, they were not opening just the Bible. They were opening up a covenant arrangement. They were opening up. So when they taught, they were not teaching from a church perspective, meaning, hope y'all will understand. No, this is covenant we're talking about now. And God is the one that let his son hang on that cross and shed his blood. Jesus said, for the remission of your sins. Now I'm opening that Bible with a whole fresh revelation. Because this is now God talking to me of who I am now, what I have now, and what I can do because of who I'm in covenant with. Somebody, y'all falling today. So that's why the Lord put in my heart, so when I came back with that revelation back in 1993, I had some board members that came from, you know, I thought I was supposed to just get any kind of board members, but I didn't know that, you know, everybody don't need to be on your board member because they don't know how to believe God. And they thought their whole job was to keep me down. Because, man, I came out with a fire. I was a blaze of fire. Are you following me? I knew we was headed for millions. Like after the earth, we're talking about millions of dollars. I knew we were headed for millions of dollars. I knew it was headed for thousands. And so, but they were saying, you know, they said, because, you know, I never been to college. But yet I've studied enough to be in college. Matter of fact, a friend's university gave me I got two doctorates. I got one doctorate degree, which it was an honorary doctorate. I got another degree that's an earned doctorate. But the president of the university, Dr. Craig, he said, you have more information on all thousands of pages of notes plus four books. He said, most people that have earned doctorates don't have. So I'm giving you an earned doctorate. So I actually have an earned doctorate from Friends International University from the president himself. Are y'all following me? Because of all the things that I've learned and stuff like that over the years in my writings and stuff I did. So I didn't get by. When I say I've never been to college, it doesn't mean I ain't been to college. I just didn't go to the natural. But, if you look at some of my pages, some of my notes and stuff like that, you see thousands upon thousands upon thousands of pages. Are you following me? When I came back, they thought because I'd never been to a natural school like they did, that I didn't have the enough sense to run a church. And I just told them one day, I said, you know what? I said, it seemed to me God didn't got my sense. That he put somebody like me, like dumb, and not you in this, as a pastor.
Amen.
All right. It seemed like God knew what he's doing. He put me up here instead of you. He got you. Are you following me? So I wouldn't let nobody. I wouldn't let nobody talk me down.
Amen.
I knew who I was. I was in blood covenant with God, and I had been sent by God. He was now obligated to grow this church. He was obligated to cause me to move into the $1,000,000,000 finances. He was obligated because I knew too much about him to stay broke now. And it wasn't pride. It was my confidence in my blood covenant with God. Are y'all following me?
Yes.
You know, we've been talking about this year. It's been a year. This is a year of restoration, right? And you know, I said, you know, I said, Lord, I said, praise God. I said, Lord, I says, it's time for my restoration.
Yeah.
You know, over the last few years, you know, we let a lot of things go, and the church ministry went through some things. And so I said, God's the restoration. So my home was restored this year.
Amen.
Brand new home.
Hallelujah.
Brand new home. Amen. Built from the ground. Amen. And so the other day, the Lord been putting on my heart, you know, how about your car? You know, because, you know, I had my Rolls Royce, I had my Phantom, but I really didn't want to, you know, get a Rolls yet because, because I'm still working on things on the house right now. But I just had an itch. Any of y'all just had an itch?
Yeah.
Just, Lord, it's like the time that came up here in the living room, the water break.
Yeah.
My water broke. And I knew it was time for delivery.
All right.
And so I said, well, God, you know, Rolls Royce, because I don't want them kind of payments right now. But then God told me, how about the Mercedes? There's a Mercedes that is right under a Maybach. It's a Mercedes. It's a S600. You got the 500, the 550, S600. Got TVs in the back. So God told me, he said, call these people. They was up in Newport Beach. And God put on my heart. How many know God? If God can tell Peter what a fish was with the money in the mouth,
that's right.
He just said, what did he say? Go down there and look in the fish's mouth, down there, and the first thing he gets is some money in his mouth. God know what a fish is. You don't need a whole lot of fish. You need one fish.
Right.
He said, go down there, and it was this place there in Newport Beach. And I said, you know what? I said, I just trade the one I got in. I don't want to put no money down, and I want to make a deal before I come there.
Come on, sit right there.
Because I ain't got time to sit in no room.
All right, come on.
So I made the deal.
Amen.
I made the deal before I left Vegas. And and they took my other vehicle, paid it off, no money down. And I came back with a Mercedes S600. Now, people may say that's karma, but no, that's restoration. We said it's a year of restoration. And to me, that's not just a theme. When I say God said that, yeah. My covenant God told me that. Yes, so me and Bill went down there. That's why I'm a little tired right now. We went down there yesterday. We drove all the way down there, drove back to Newport Beach, California, Mercedes dealership. And they was waiting on me down there. Never didn't know me. But I left out there. Y'all was talking about, pray for me, Dr. Craig, pray for me. They seen God's anointing on me. Come on, y'all. So there's some things I know about prosperity, not carnal, but how to go into the realm of the spirit, and how to pull things that are already yours, that are already yours by inheritance. I didn't drive it down here. The only reason I didn't drive it down here because I ain't got nowhere to park it. I ain't gonna be parking in an area where people don't know how to treat things. I parked it one time at a hotel. We was at a Marriott Menard in Prescott. Nice hotel. Came out there, I had my Phantom, and somebody had scratched it up. You got haters. Somebody say amen. So I will drive it, but I got to get to a hotel in Scottsdale. They let you park in the front. I ain't going to be parking my car, no lie. You got to know how to treat certain things. No, really, they keyed it from the beginning, from the front to the back. It cost the insurance company $17,000 to fix a scratch on that car. So that's all right, y'all on your way to heaven, right?
That's right.
Heaven got better than a Rolls Royce. Amen. Y'all got streets of gold, so don't that look $17,000. God said, "Oh, that's all." God said something. God can handle that with no problem. Thank God. But see, the thing is, the insurance company. I'm trying to take y'all somewhere today. The insurance company tried to give me a ticket to a regular paint shop, and the Rolls Royce said, no, don't take it there. They said, you take it down here, well, we take our cars too, because they know how to paint Rolls Royces. The other people, they'll put like you paint a Chevrolet, these are Rolls Royces, you paint one section at a time. And if you take anything off, you don't put it back on there again. See, everybody said we're getting ready for heaven. See, that heaven got going on now, I'm telling you. Amen. You think that's big right there, wait till you get to heaven. Oh my God. Amen. So are y'all ready?
Yes,
so my lesson today is gonna be this: claiming your covenant compensation. How many know when you get to a job, you wanna know what's gonna be your compensation?
Yeah.
Ain't that right? What are the benefits? What is my compensation here? So notice this is gonna be in Genesis chapter 15 and verse 1. This is in the Amplified version of the Bible. It says, what after these things, right? The word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision, saying, fear not, Abraham, I am your what? Shield, your what? Your abundant compensation, and your reward shall be exceedingly great. Can y'all see that today? So when God, you in covenant with God, he said, I am your shield. I am your abundant compensation. See, can you read, y'all read, let me go to that scripture right now, but you read there in the book of Genesis, chapter 13, it said Abraham became very rich.
Yes.
Still go, why? Because God said, I am your abundant compensation. I am your abundant compensation. You got to recognize you're in covenant with somebody that has an abundant compensation prepared for you. He said, and your reward shall be what exceedingly great. And then notice Genesis chapter 17 and verse number 1. It says what? And when Abram was what? 90 years old and 9. Everybody said, you're not too old.
Not too old.
With my days on, no, you ain't too old. And when Abram was 90 years old and 9, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. In verse 2, and I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly.
Amen.
Everybody said he's talking to me right there. Because the Bible says if you be Christ, then are you Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. So you got to see that when God told Abraham, he's talking to you. Is that right? Yeah. So when God said, I bless Abraham, he said, that's, that blessing's on my life. Yeah. Like Alfred said, I want my dad God. Mm-hmm. See, so you in covenant, I want everything, so everything that God got, I want it because I'm in covenant with him. Yeah. In the old days, the stronger always, or the weaker always looked for to be in covenant with the stronger. Because when the weaker got in covenant with the stronger, the weaker became strong. And that's why God said, I am your abundant. My covenant is between me and you. And I'm going to multiply you exceedingly. Can I put that on this church right now? Can I release that on this church right now? Hallelujah. Are y'all ready to get that released on you right now? That I decree right now, you in covenant with Almighty God. And God said, I'm going to multiply you exceedingly. Glory to God. And he said, and by the way, I am your abundant compensation. Don't you look for nobody else. Don't look for nobody else to do it. Glory to God, because I am. And it, what's the name of this church?
I am.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right, all right. Amen. Y'all got that?
Yes, sir.
Amen. So get ready for a swift lifting. Get ready for a shifting in your finances. Now, I'm dealing with that because what God's taking you to, you got the vision. I'm talking about the provision for the vision. We're not talking about just getting a car, just getting a house. I'm talking about the provision for your vision at the level God got for your life. And y'all found it today. So this is a point that when God is your abundant compensation, you will no longer have to believe for a budget. Glory to God. Hey, now that's freeing right there. Come on, I'd be up at night with that calculator and it wasn't coming up right. Huh? But when God is your abundant compensation, you want to believe for a budget? You have to believe for how much is going to come in? How many people going to come? How many people going to show up? You'll just leave God alone and let him do it. And you'll find out he always comes through. Are y'all following that? So not that you shouldn't have a budget. No, wrong with a budget. But God said, I am. Beyond that budget that you're believing for, I am your abundant compensation. And I will multiply you what? Exceedingly. Because my covenant is between me and you. And see, God had to show me that, you know, y'all heard the story about when I needed an air conditioning unit. You heard the story before. I needed an air conditioning unit, and it's my first time having a large building like that. And I had like five AC units. I had a 25-ton, a 15-ton, 10-ton, and several 4-ton units on that building. And I think the 25-ton, whether the 15-ton or 25-ton went out. It would cost $10,000 just to repair that thing. And I looked at my budget, and it wasn't there. I looked at the people. I didn't see it there. I look at my normal, regular budget, monthly budget. It was not in there. And I didn't want to come before the people that morning and say, I need $10,000 over and above the budget today because, you don't want to put that kind of pressure on people. Right. When you're in covenant, you no longer have to put the pressure on people. You keep it on God. Because right. He said, I am your abundant compensation. Yes. Is that right? Yes. And so y'all know the story about, like I said, my baby daughter wanted me to... to look at Lion King with her, and I didn't want to watch Lion King because I was depressed because my budget was buzzing in my ear. And I watched the little monkey, the donkey, that's another one. That's the donkey is another one. But I watched the little bird and the pig. And the little lion was kind of depressed. I identified the little lion because he was depressed, I was depressed. Budgets will make you depressed. Especially when you ain't got the money for it. And so then, the Lord put in my heart, they were singing this song, Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata means don't worry for the rest of your life. It's a carefree philosophy, Hakuna Matata. And I was, what is this song meaning? I don't understand what it's meaning. And the Lord put in my heart, he said, that's in the Bible. I said, that's in the Bible? He said, yeah, Hakuna Matata is in the Bible. 1 Peter 5:7 says, casting all your care on him. For he, your abundant compensation, cares for you. Huh? And then I repented because, Lord, you know, God, I've read that scripture, but not in this context before. Are you following me? That's why I keep telling testimonies. You know, when the Bible said when David killed Goliath, it said he carried his head around for several days, reminding himself that God killed the giant through my hands. Yes. So I keep my testimonies alive all the time of the goodness of God. So, you know, never forget what God has done and how God did it because it was supernatural. And like I said, you heard me say I came to church that Sunday morning. I didn't put no pressure on people because I didn't try to raise that kind of money because I didn't, you know, it's kind of tough. I couldn't sell them any chicken dinners that day. Can't have any bake sales. What am I going to do? God is my abundant compensation. Casting all your care on him, for he cares for you. Amen. Now, I think it's Psalm 55:11. I believe it says, cast thy burden on the Lord, releasing the weight of it on him. Like the Amplified Bible says, releasing the weight of it on him, and he shall sustain thee. Thank you, Lord. And I said, okay, God, I'm going to do that. And I remember I went to lunch, my finance person came and said, Dr. Craig, the same amount of money came in as always. He said, but one more extra check came in that day. God showed up. The abundant compensator showed up. Amen. I said, how much was the check? He said, $80,000.
Hallelujah.
$80,000. That was enough to take care of the AC unit and a whole lot more things. God is. Now, see, you don't get this kind of thing in many churches because a lot of times pastors are afraid to talk about money in the church. And that's why the church ain't got no money. That's why they got to have car washes and bake sales and chicken dinners because the pastor's scared to teach this. But if you're going to have a vision that God is doing in your life, you're going to have to understand this. Are y'all following me? So when God is your abundant compensation, he will destroy all money control of your life. Money will control you. It'll control you. It'll keep you from sleeping at night. It'll make you and your wife or husband argue, almost fight, get divorces. All because of, what was it? Was it Isaac Brothers?
The OJ.
OJs. Money, money, money. It'll make you do all kind of crazy things. Huh? But once you get a hold of this, money will no longer control of your life, and you'll never have to go after money anymore. People ask me all the time, Dr. Craig, why don't you have anniversaries? Nothing wrong with anniversaries. A lot of pastors have anniversaries. I'm not getting to that. But I've never had one because, to me, I'm putting too much pressure on people again. I don't never want people to say what they did for me. Because then I'm going to drop my Rolls Royce. I want you to, thank God for mother, your mother, your mom. When I first mentioned about getting my Rolls Royce that time, this one lady told me, I'm going to throw some money on that. And I said, no, nobody getting the money on my Rolls Royce. I don't need nobody to say that you taking my money and buying a Rolls Royce with it. And her mother stopped me on the way out. And said, like, Craig, you just said what you did was just right, because she used to work for IRS, right? Was it IRS or something she used to work for? Your mom. Internal Revenue. She said, because that's what's happening a lot, is preachers letting people buy them stuff like that, and then, you know, and people report them. And so Dr. Price told me the same thing. Don't let your church buy that, because you got members in your church that will be reporting you, somebody, what you're doing with the money. Right. So when I buy my Rolls, nobody could say, I gave one penny toward my Rolls Royce. Are you following me? So that's why I don't have those kind of things myself. Nothing wrong with it. People have it. I'm not putting nobody down. I don't do it because I don't need nobody saying what they did for Dr. Craig. That's right. If God leads you to give me some money, I'll take it all day long. Right. But don't you never give me no money, but you're going to be able to come back and say, I did this. Right. See, my mom helped me out there. She said, she stopped me on the way. I said, Dr. Craig, what you did was just correct. So that's why I don't do a lot of those things, because God is my compensation. Like Abraham said, I won't take your money because I don't want nobody to say, God, that you made me rich. God made me rich. See, you follow me? So when God is your compensation, you don't have to do all those games and stuff. God knows how to come through. I said, God knows how to come through for you. Hallelujah. Amen. So therefore, how are we going to begin to claim our conversation then? Number one, don't never go after money. You may say, Dr. Creighton, I thought you should believe in prosperity. I do, but I don't go after it. That's the thing. See, people go after it. And that's when you start getting all this. You got to try to figure out all kind of ways of doing things. You follow me? Never go, but go after God. Never go after money. Go after God and then serve and help people. See, the key to any success is finding people that are hurting and find a way to heal them. Find people down and find a way to lift them up. Find people poor and find a way to help get their needs met. Because now I'm on assignment from God. Huh? So I don't go after the money. I go after God. Now, I believe God for finance. Remember, I believe God for finances. But I don't never put the pressure on people for it. Huh? I go after God, and then I serve and help people. So the church will grow as you keep serving and helping people. And out of the overflow of what God blessing them, they'll bless you automatically. People will bless you because you've been a blessing to them. Huh? Amen. And that's why I don't mind anniversaries. But it should be because people just want to be a blessing to you and not say, we're giving our pastor an anniversary. Like, we're doing this. No. If you want to do it, that's fine. Be led by the Spirit of God to do it. But don't do it where people can start thinking they are the one doing it. And then somebody called me, they told me not long ago, they said, Dr. Craig, I'm in this one church, and they're requiring every member to give $100. So that's what I'm saying. That's going after money then. Yeah. Now, if every member want to give $100, fine. But I might stop and I want to give $1,000. Right. So that person feel pressured because they was requiring everybody, they was having this dinner, they was requiring everybody to buy a ticket for the dinner, and then they was requiring everybody to also, every member get $100. But those kind of requirements is what I'm talking about, don't go after. Y'all don't get quiet on me now.
Yes, sir.
Everybody say, God is my abundant compensation. I'm in covenant with him. Are y'all following today? Now, if everybody want to have a nice dinner, like I like what Alfred said about y'all going to have a dinner, that's wonderful. See, I'm talking about, but no pressure there. He said, if you want to go, that's no pressure there. But when there's pressure, people feel pressure to do it. Now it's activity. Now it's religion. And the people, you know, but I've learned this over the years that if I pursue God and bless people, the blessings will come. So what I do, this is what I do, I make sure that people are blessed. And I make sure I prepare myself to minister to people. Not what I can get from them. Now, don't get me wrong, I like when people give me the Holy Ghost handshakes. And I love that. Praise the name of Jesus. I told my other day, I said, brother, you can shake my hand every day. They always give them Pentecostal handshakes. I love them kind of handshakes. So I'm not talking about going to get, not having money. I love that. But this whole thing about these games people be playing. You don't have to do that. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Look at this now. See, if you go after money, money becomes your master.
Yeah. That's it right there.
Matthew 6:24 says, no man can what?
Serve.
Can serve two masters. You will either hate the one and love the other. Or you will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon, which you cannot serve God and the money God. Because you got the money will become your God. It'll keep them going to church on Sunday because I got to work. I got to rest for tomorrow, go to work. See, money becoming their God. There's a lot of people sometimes, pastors have a hard time getting members to come back to church again after the corona. People have come, and a lot of them is not because of they're afraid, they're because they just got comfortable at home.
Right.
Are y'all following? Now, and the thing about it is, thank God for Facebook. Facebook's been great. Thank God over the last year we have Facebook to be able to get people, feed people the word of God. But there's nothing can take the place of fellowship that you get in a church. Because God said, forsake not the assembling yourselves together as a manner of some is. So that you, even though it's good to have Facebook, which we love that. Thank God for that. But that being under a pastor that can really meet your needs and you grow with that church. You don't just watch it grow, you help it grow. You can be on Facebook and they'll be a part of a congregation and you're missing out on a whole lot. And so with people, they don't stay home when it's time to go to work. They don't stay home when it's time to go buy groceries. They're going to get them something to eat. But when they come down and go into church, they stay home. Money has become their God. They'll do more to get money than they do to get fed the word of God. If you go after money, your money will stay small because you can't be trusted with it. Because the moment God starts blessing you with more, you start going outside. And you was paying tithe and offerings, now you're barely tithing. And some of them was tithing, you went from tithing to tipping.
Come on, Apostle, help us.
Money will become your God. And I believe in prosperity. You be me? I believe in prosperity. You see this? That's prosperity. I believe. But what's happening is people are going after that. I didn't buy this. This was given to me. I didn't buy this. My ring. This was given to me. I normally have a Rolex watch on. That was given to me. I didn't buy none of those. All that was given to me by people. They just said, Dr. Craig, we want to bless you. I didn't go after none of that. Money can become your God. And this has happened a lot in the body of Christ, which was keeping people from really understanding the revelation that God wants you blessed. 1 Timothy 6:10 says what? For the love of money, not money, the love of money is the root of all evil, which some what? Coveted after. I mean, you're doing all kinds of things to get it. They have erred from the faith. They was walking in faith. They was coming to church every Sunday. They was giving tithe and offerings. And now money got a hold to them. Now they got to work two jobs to keep up on. You know, they were going after the house, but not God. They got the house. Now they ain't got time because they got to work two jobs. Now they can't come to church no more. Because that love of the money and what things can get caused them to err from the faith, it says. And pierce themselves through with many sorrows. When you're going after money, man, it'll produce many sorrows in your life. Because you're going after it. Hallelujah. So it's not money, but the love of money when you start coveting after it. And when it says, and it calls you to err from what? The faith. You're no longer in faith no more. Now you're trying to work two jobs, three jobs. You know what I mean? You're not coming to church all because of, what is that, money, money, money. Huh? It calls you air from the faith and pierce yourself through with many sorrows. If you keep going with the money, money will take God's place in your life. It'll cause you to put your faith in your academic abilities. Proverbs 10:22 says what? It says what? The blessing of the Lord, it makes rich and has no sorrow with it. When God is blessing you, you ain't got to work two or three jobs to stay home from church. It'll make you rich with no sorrow. The love of money will pierce you through with many sorrows. You can't sleep at night. Hair falling out. Got ulcers going off on everybody because of the love of money. But the blessing of the Lord, that's what God wants to walk. He wants to walk in the blessing. He wants to walk in the blessing. The blessing will make you rich. It said it will make you rich. You got that? But see, and that's what, see, so we want to walk in the what? In the blessing with no sorrow. That I can sleep at night. God is saying, if you go, if you don't go after money, he said, I will see to it that you have it. Amen. Just follow his steps. Y'all all right? Matthew 6:23 says what? But seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. That's what God wants us to be at right there. Seeking his kingdom worldwide, expanding his kingdom, loving God, serving people, blessing people, and all these things. God now becomes my employer. I'm his employee. Hallelujah. Isaiah 1:19 says what? If you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. That's what God said. Just follow my instructions. You ain't got to go out. You ain't got to go through all those games and stuff. Just follow my instructions. If you be willing and obedient, you will eat the good of the land. See, I don't know about y'all. When I look at this, I mean, y'all on that good land right now. I don't know if y'all know what's really happening in y'all's life. Y'all came a long way from the weed church. Oh, my God. Y'all came a long way from the weed church. And walking in a lot, I walk in there today, I say, oh my God, the change is happening. Why? Things have been added to you. Y'all been going after God. And things have been added unto you. You're being willing and obedient to God. You're serving people. You're helping people. You're blessing people. Job 36:11 says what? If they what? Obey and serve him, they will spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. See, get rid of all that religion. Just learn to obey God, serve him, and serve people. Bless people, lift people, make people smile. And God has said, you do that, you will spend your days in prosperity and your years and pleasures. Amen. Hallelujah. And then St. John, chapter 15, verse 7 says what? This is Jesus talking. If you what? Abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. God said, I'm your employer. I'm your abundant compensation. I'm in covenant with you. If you just abide in me, get rid of all that religion, think you got to do all these things to make things happen?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
I like what Alfred said earlier, that we fellowship people that got integrity. Because some people just come, they just want to invite me to their church, and you know why? Because then they want me to say, Dr. K, when you lift the offering, they were trying to manipulate that.
Yeah.
And that's why I stopped going to church, because they thought because I walk on a level of anointing, that when Dr. Craig comes, he can raise some money for us. I said, I ain't going to do that because that you're trying to prostitute my anointing. So I stopped going there because people had the wrong ideas. Well, you're going to bring some of your members, Pastor Craig. You know why they want to bring my members? Because they know my members have been taught to give. Are you going to bring your members with you? No, you invited me. Come on, y'all. Are you following me? Now, if we know they got integrity, we can invite the members to come. But some people, they got all the manipulative things that they do because they don't understand covenant and how to believe God and that God's conversation, they have to run, they come up with all these games. You scratch my back, I scratch your back. But God said, if you abide in me and my words, and what words? I am your abundant conversation. I'm in covenant with you. You can ask what you will.
Yeah.
God says that's a blank check.
Yeah.
You ain't got to go through all these changes.
Yeah.
You can ask what you will.
Yeah.
And we're saying, it shall be done unto you.
Yes.
But if you keep working for a check, you keep working on all these manipulations, you're going to always stay broke. You're never going to really move into biblical prosperity. But if you go after God and you go after blessing people, the blessings will follow you. And you will like to get stacked up. Everybody says stacked up blessings. Well, this is a scripture God gave me. This is back in 1980. But in 1982, we were living in the bottom of the church in Coolidge, Arizona. The church is about this big on top, a little larger than this. 8 rooms downstairs. The swimming pool was Alfred's. The baptismal pool was Alfred's swimming pool. Living in the bottom of the church. But I was seeking God. I was going after God. And about 3 o'clock in the morning, as I was at the altar praying, the Lord gave me this scripture right here. Because I went after him. I had been a successful hairdresser. But I was going after God. I said, God, I'm trying to make this transition out of the business world into being a pastor. It ain't working. But I know you can do it because I see so many people. So I said, God, I'm going to go after you for a moment. So, for 9 months, we was in the bottom of the church. 9 months. It was about 9 months. Something like 9 months in the church. We didn't have a shower. We had to have a tub. Hot water. Yeah. That's see? And this is after I had been a hairdresser. But I was making a transition out of the natural, nothing wrong with business. I was in business, I still love hairdressing. But God was he was transitioning me into full-time ministry, and I didn't know how to do it. Are you following? But he got to teach me how to believe him. I knew how to believe for hairdresser because I was an excellent hairdresser. I knew how to believe him in the business world, but I didn't know how to believe him in the church world. Everybody I've been around was manipulating and have all these games. But I've been in the streets. I knew games. I could stay in the streets if I wanted to keep running games. I came in the church. They were still running the same games. I know that game right there. I know that one too already. You follow me? I come from the streets. I know you can't pull that off on me. I already know all that. I want to learn about how God does it. That God is my abundant compensation. If I'm going to be in this thing, I want to know how it works. So about 2 o'clock in the morning, God gave me this scripture. It lit up for me. In Deuteronomy 28:1, it says what? And it shall come to pass. Everybody say, no, I want this to be, I want you to be me back in 1982. And I want you to go back at 3 o'clock in the morning when you're up to with the calculator trying to figure out your budget. Amen. And I want the Lord to just appear to you right now and give this to you. Are y'all ready? And it shall come to pass, if you shall hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord your God, to observe to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord, everybody say the Lord.
The Lord.
The Lord will set you on high above all nations of the earth. And verse 2, and all these blessings, you know what blessing means? Empowerment to prosper. All these blessings shall come on you and overtake you. You ain't got to go after them. They're going to come after you. And overtake you if you shall hearken to the voice of God. A lot of voices out there, y'all. A lot of religious voices. But it's the voice that God talks to you about. Overtake you if you shall hearken to the voice of the Lord your God. Verse 3, bless. Shall you be in the weed church? Blessed shall you be off any school road. And blessed shall you not be in Thomas. Huh? Blessed shall you be in the city. And blessed shall you be in the field. Wherever you at, the blessing will be on your life. Verse 4, blessed shall be the fruit of your body, your kids, and the fruit of your ground, your business, the fruit of your cattle, your customers. And the increase of your kind, the flocks of your sheep. That's talking about business and church and everything to do to the main provision in your life. And blessed shall be your basket in your store. That means your savings account and your checking account and your IRAs and your whatever other kind of A's you got. God said the blessing gonna come on that thing, and money is start coming out everywhere. And blessed, verse 6, blessed shall you be when you come in, and blessed shall you be when you go out. People tell sometimes myself and my wife, we walk in places sometimes. And they said, Dr. Craig, when y'all walk in, it seems like royalty walks in. I said, that's right, because we are.
All right.
And I said, well, no, we are royalty.
That's right.
So we do light up the room when we come in.
Yes.
Amen. We are royalty. I was at a memorial the other day, And this one gentleman, he was a wonderful guy. He was an apostle. He said, "Elder Craig, when you walk in, it's like a general walked in." I said, "That's right.
Amen.
I am in the kingdom of God." So I don't apologize for being who I am. I don't go, "Well, you know, it's all." No. I am. God says I am. So whoever I am, say I am. You'll never see a general in the natural army go around talking about, "No, I'm just a corporal." No, he said, "I'm a general. I paid the price to be a general."
Amen. Come on.
Hallelujah. Y'all see, I told you about my car. I ain't going to hide nothing.
No.
You can't handle it, then go to hell.
Come on.
Because you don't want to go to heaven.
That's it.
No, if you can't handle me driving a car, you don't want to go to heaven. Ain't nothing poor in heaven. Ain't nothing broke in heaven. So if you can't handle prosperity, go to hell. That's where all the broke folks are going. They're all going to hell. People that don't want, you know. Because in hell, you're going, you know, so folks don't want nothing. But if you're ready for opulence at its best, if you're ready for prosperity at its best, where the streets are gold and the gates are pearl, and we don't need no electricity, for the glory of God is lighting up the whole place. If you wait for that, then come on, glory. But if you want to be broke, busted, and disgusted, go to hell.
Come on, God.
We ain't got time to hide nothing from you.
Yes, sir.
You're broke with your broke self. That's what's been wrong with people all the time. The body of Christ, you've been afraid to be the children of a king. You've been afraid to be who you really are.
Yeah.
Trying to stand for all these broke folks, all these religious folks. It's time to come out of that. You got kingdom business to do. You got a worldwide ministry to accomplish. You got people to help. You got people to lift. People to bless. Like Pastor Noel Southtown said, you know, we're a family.
Yeah.
I mean, if somebody in this family, you know, need a house, we'll buy your house.
Yeah.
Need a car, we'll buy your car.
Yeah. That's it.
We'll help you get going.
Yeah.
That's prosperity.
Yes,
we are here in Jesus' stead.
Yes,
everything he did, he said, "The works I did, you shall do also." So he, when Peter needs money, by his face, Jesus said, "Go down and check with the fish down there." You see, we are anointed by the Holy Ghost to take Jesus' place on this earth to do the work that he did and greater. So stop apologizing for God being your compensation. Stop apologizing for being blessed in the city and being blessed in the field. Oh, I got to do it. Y'all ready? Hallelujah! Glory to God.
Yes. Yes. God, that's what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
Glory.
Yes, sir. Glory. 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 Glory.
Take it or leave.
Take it or leave. That's right. We sitting around wasting our time on these folks.
Yeah.
Trying to be nice. No. Jesus was not. Jesus said, "You hypocrite."
Oh.
You vipers, you snakes, you think I'm hard. Jesus was really hard on him. He loved sinners, but he was hard on hypocrites and religious people. And my job as your apostle is to help get this thing settled in this church. It's time to stop, y'all. Can I just finish y'all's blessing? I just finished it off. It's time for the stop. Ready? All right, so we stopped at verse 7, right?
Yep.
The Lord shall cause your enemies, just in case they try, that rise up against you to be smitten before your face. They shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways. Like that one person on Facebook. Ain't nobody got time for that. That's right. Amen. Verse 8. And the Lord, not folks, the Lord shall command the blessing upon you. Now, y'all know about commands?
Yes, sir.
Is command a suggestion?
No, sir.
When a command is, there's no option.
No.
The Lord shall command, because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. He said, the Lord shall command blessing upon thee in your storehouses, businesses, churches, your homes, and your cars, plural, in your storehouses, and in all that you set your hand unto. Hallelujah. Look how God worked this thing out. You set your hand to this, God worked this thing out. Everybody said, more to come. He shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Your own church building, y'all build your own self. Verse 9, the Lord shall. Can you see he's about the Lord, the Lord, the Lord? See, then we're getting rid of all these people trying to manipulate you. I'm the one helping. No, wait a minute, wait a minute. Did God do it through you? No, I know. All right. We don't need you no more. Because you're trying to manipulate us. Like this one lady, we mentioned, this has been years ago, We were talking about getting an airplane. This is back a long time ago. And this one lady, they gave a dollar or something on it. So about 6 months later, she said, where the airplane at? I get one. You gave a dollar. You know, they wasn't even at the bottom, one of the nuts on the wheels.
That's right.
Where your airplane at? A lady in the ministry actually did that. She like $1, $5 on the airplane. I gave money on this airplane. Where my airplane at? Wow. And that's why you got to trust God. Amen. He'll work through people. Yes. He'll work through people. Yes. But it's got to come from God. Yes. Yes. You got to keep your eyes on God. Because people will try to manipulate and try to hold you hostage.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 9, and the Lord shall establish thee a holy people unto himself, as he has sworn unto thee, if thou shalt what? Keep the commandments of the Lord thy God to walk in his ways. Verse 10, and all people of the earth shall see that you are called by the name of the Lord and shall be scared of you. You know, I use country, we call it scared. Y'all call it afraid. But it's scared. I'm scared of you. Be afraid. But that means they're going to reverence. What they're saying is, don't touch that person.
That's right.
That's what it's not afraid in the sack of fear means. They're stepping on you. We don't know what it is. We don't like him. But we can't stop what he's doing.
Right.
Or what she's doing. Because
the
stepping on them is called the blessing.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Verse 11, and the Lord shall make thee plenty good. See, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about switching. Let's switch. The Lord shall make you plenteous in goods, in the fruit of your body, and in the fruit of your cattle, and the fruit of, that's all your business and your ministry, anything God's going on, in the fruit of your ground, in the land which the Lord swore to our fathers to give thee. The fathers referring to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the covenant. He's talking about covenant there. Verse 12, and the Lord shall open to you, oh my God, are y'all ready for this?
Yes, sir.
His good treasure. What if Warren Buffett gave you his checking account? Bill Gates gave you his checking account. Open up his good treasure to you. Well, for God, that's called peanuts to God. See, we got to enlarge God in our minds. That God is saying, I'm going to open to you my good treasure. I am your abundant compensation. The heaven. Gonna get rain into your land this season and bless how much? All the work of your hand, and you shall lend unto many nations and shall not borrow. Ain't nothing wrong with borrowing, but God, you're gonna come out of debt. All your bills gonna get paid off in Jesus' name. Because sometimes you first start, you gotta borrow, just get your house, get your car, nothing wrong with that at all. But God's gonna bring it to a point. You're going to pay cash because of the blessing of the favor of God on your life. Verse 13, he says, and the Lord shall, can you see the Lord? I want you to keep this, the Lord is doing it. The Lord shall make you the head and not the tail. And you shall be above only and not beneath. They sing this song, sometimes up, sometimes down, sometimes almost level to the ground. That ain't what God says. Because you're going to be above only. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, you shall be above only and not beneath. Well, child, that's too good to be true. No, it's good and it's true. Well, child, nothing good lasts too long. That ain't what God says. See, that's all the world's thinking. But God says above only. You got to believe you deserve to have an above only life. Say, you need to believe that you have the right to have an above only life. When God is your compensation and you're operating out of his treasure. I don't know if y'all see what the Spirit of God is saying today. Above, let me hear not tell above and only, not beneath. And if you shall hearken to the voice of the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command thee this day. And that's what God says. The whole goal is seeking God, not money. I believe in money. Y'all been remembering, I believe in prosperity. But you got to seek God and not the money. I'm saying you got to seek God. You seek the money. Money becomes your God. It becomes your master. Then all of a sudden it's manipulating you. And it'll keep you to a certain level. But if you go after God and let him bless you. Hallelujah. Well, y'all, that's enough for this month. That's only the first part of the message I got for y'all. It's some very good points in there that I need to still bring out. But that's a point. It's something about that, about going after God. Because sometimes what people mistaken people like me, we teach prosperity, and they forget, they get the wrong impression. They never talk about going after money. But it's not going after money, you go after God. Amen. And you learn his principles. Amen. Seek first his kingdom, his righteousness, and those things be added to you. But we have to talk about money sometimes because we have to break that spirit of poverty. So we do have to come down on certain things to break that spirit of poverty, but really it's going after God. It's going after God. See, that's why I got thousands upon thousands upon thousands. My wife tell you I got thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands of pages of notes that I've written over the years. I write something about the 40 pages of notes just for one sermon. Because I'm a researcher. I make sure that when I stand up here, I got something to say and I know what I'm saying. Are you following me? So I'm not teaching something that's out of just my head. So I go after God, and I go after people, blessing people, helping people, lifting people. Come on, give God some praise. Amen. So, and I'm teaching because what Pastor Alan Noel taking y'all in his local church, I'm trying to teach it because this is what's going to make it happen exponentially. Exponentially? What does that mean, fast? Expeditiously? I make sure I get my words right. I'm from the country. I could say it in country terms, but I'm trying to say it in the right way. You know what I mean? Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. Your blessing, hurry up and come. Hallelujah. I decree that everything I've said over your life in Jesus' name today, that it has been good seed sown on good ground, that no enemy will be able to pull it up, but it will bear fruit, and the fruit will remain, and it will be shortly and swiftly manifested in your life, in your family, in your personal life, in your physical health, and in your finances. I declare it in Jesus' name, and no weapon formed against you will prosper, and every tongue that rises against you to keep you from going that way will be condemned. I pray that every person that the devil send your way will be removed, will be revealed, exposed, and removed out of your life. That's trying to block your progress. They're trying to block your success. They're trying to block the growth of this church, this ministry, your business. I declare every enemy sniffed out of your life swiftly in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. for this church shall grow swiftly. The ministry shall grow swiftly. People shall come in here swiftly with hunger and a thirst for God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I call them from the north, the south, the east, and the west. The winds of heaven blowing them into this place in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hungry and thirsty after God. And they'll come seeking God, but then they'll see things added to their life. They'll see healing added to their life. They'll see victory added to their life. They'll see prosperity added to their life. They'll see health added to their life. But it comes not by seeking healing, but it comes by seeking the healer. It comes not by seeking provision, but it comes by seeking the provider. And if you seek him first and his kingdom, I declare before Almighty God today, all these things shall be added unto you. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Well, praise God. Do you want to do communion first, Alfred, or tithe offer first? Okay, all right, we'll do communion first. But you know, communion is going to settle this thing. Because Jesus, he came and he said to the disciples, he said, y'all come close. He said this. He said, now, this bread is my body broken for you. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Now, remember I said earlier about sending Pastor Cedric to the Rolls Royce dealership?
Yeah.
But before he left out, y'all want to go ahead and pass those out if you want to?
Yeah. They're going to come around.
Okay, good. All right, praise God. Okay, y'all going to come around? Okay, y'all going to direct them to come around? Okay, good. Now, this is what I want you to see, y'all. Yeah, you just go ahead and direct them while I'm talking there. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
I want y'all to see, I just called y'all back in before I sent y'all out.
Thank you, Lord.
And we're going to break bread together. We're going to go in covenant together. Hallelujah. Go ahead and come on around, y'all. I'm following instructions. I know how to follow instructions. There y'all go. Hallelujah. You know, there's an anointing here. I don't know if y'all understand. Some things have been broken here today. Some things have been broken here today.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I don't know if I'm not doing it in order, y'all, but y'all just blessed me today. Thank you. Thank you, daughter.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. That's right. Because I want y'all to envision something. We take this today. I want you to envision. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Lord God of heaven. You might want to turn that off, especially if we're still on Facebook.
Yes.
Probably want to turn that off then, because Facebook will cut us off with that music. But I love that music, though.
Okay.
But they cut us. I don't know why they do. They cut it. I guess because some of that music is copywritten.
Right.
But then once we get there, once we got Facebook, they will turn the music back on. All right. Thank y'all very much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, what I want you all to see. Okay, here we go.
Thank you, Lord.
There we go.
Thank you, Lord.
Good, excellent, excellent. All right. Well, what I want you all to see, remember I mentioned earlier about me sending Pastor Cedric to go to Rolls Royce, and he was kind of stumbling around at first. Because he was just going by what I said. But then I had him come back, and I had him to, we cut covenant together. And because of his understanding of covenant, after that, he had a pep in his step. Only thing changed is what I put behind it. I'm telling y'all today, I just had y'all stop what you was doing, and I brought y'all into covenant with God. That after you take this, you're going to be assured, not that one day you're going to get healed, but by his stripes you were healed. Because it's a covenant thing. You're going to be assured that not only you believe in God to meet your needs, you know your needs are met. Because of now who you're in covenant with. Are you following me? The moment you get in covenant with him, like a marriage, the moment my wife went from Malone to Craig, she became all that Craig is. Yeah. Are y'all following me? When I bought that car, she rode that car with me on the way back. Boy, she enjoyed. She rode that car with me, praise God. You know why? Because now, because I bought the car, whether no matter what happened, that car, you know, we both got that car now. She rode in it.
Amen.
You know why? Because the moment her name was switched and a covenant was made, it was no longer I, but it's now us.
Amen.
Once you're in covenant with God, it's no longer God, but it's us now.
Hallelujah.
You are now a friend of God.
Hallelujah.
He's in covenant with you. As he is, so are you. So I want you to walk out here today having broke covenant with God. That every need that you and Noel need, Alfred, is met.
Right.
Not is being met, is met. And what's behind that? Covenant.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Are you ready? So, Father, I've taught the word of God today as an apostle of God, and I've shared the word of God from the revelation that you've given unto me. There's much more to go with this, Father, but I'm asking you now, the Lord, let this revelation go deep into the hearts of the people. And now, Lord, we're taking this, remembering the covenant, the blood of the New Testament. That, Lord, your body was broken for us so that blood could be shed, that we could be in covenant with you, God. That, Lord, you could now become our covenant compensation. No longer dependent on man or human flesh, but trusting you, Father. And, Lord, as we go out today after this covenant, we'll go out here as representatives of Almighty God, as covenant keepers in you, Father. And Lord, we bless this bread. That Lord, let us discern the very body of Christ that was broken for our brokenness. But by Jesus Christ, we're healed. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's take it together. Hallelujah. And then the blood. When they cut their wrists and the blood was shed, the blood went into one cup, and they stirred it, they mixed it and mingled it together, and then they drank of it, because now the two are one. His life is now my life. Are y'all got that today? So, Lord, we sanctify this blood. Your life is now our life. Your love is now our love. We're in covenant with you, God. As we leave out of this place today, Father, we don't leave out just any way, but we leave out today as heirs of God and join us with Jesus Christ through our blood covenant with you, Father. We give you thanks for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Let's take it together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Just worship God right now for a moment. Just worship him for a moment. Worship him, the creator of heaven and earth, that said, as for me, my covenant is between you and me. Hallelujah. I am your great abundant compensation. Hallelujah. And Lord, we thank you for that. We thank you for that, Father. And Lord, you set this church up as a beacon in this city. in this whole state. And Lord, we thank you for Pastor Al and Noel. We thank you for the leaders of this church, every member of this congregation. Lord, let this revelation sit strongly in this church. And let them move forth from this point on, understanding you are their abundant compensation. In Jesus' name, amen. Give God some praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. All right, you can be seated in God's presence. Hallelujah. Now, before, now y'all know, now what we're going to do now, we're going to receive our tithes and offerings.
Hallelujah.
Y'all almost got happy. We're going to receive our tithes and offerings.
Hallelujah.
Malachi 3:10. Oh, y'all got that on there already? Malachi 3:10. Let's go back just a little bit there for me. Amen. A couple scriptures behind there. That's all right. Y'all know it, huh, in this church. Malachi 3:10 says, what? Bring all the tithe into the storehouse. See, now, I thank God for the benefit of Facebook. That's a blessing. Thank God for online giving. That is a tremendous blessing. How many of you know that?
Yes.
Amen. But how many know just when you can bring it, it's even better?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I worship you. Amen. Bring all the tithes into the storehouse that there be meat in my house. And prove me now. So this is not just a time of paying your tithes. This is time of connecting with heaven. Prove me now, he would say, the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you what? The windows. Oh my God, of heaven. How big is that? The windows of heaven. And pour you out of this, not trickle. See, enlarge our minds when we read the scriptures, that there should not be room enough to receive it. Verse 11, and I will. Everybody say, God will.
God.
See, this is what talking about God being your abundant compensation. I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. And he, who is he? The devil? He shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast their fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. Y'all got that? So that's important, isn't it? So we're not just paying tithes. The world does that. We're connecting to heaven. Tithing is the covenant connector. Hallelujah. To the blessing. So that's why when we get ready for tithing, saints, it's a holy time. It's a holy time, amen? And so I believe God, this is my confession all the time, that this church is a tithing church. And there is not a God robber among us. I'm going to say again. That's my declaration, that this church is a tithing church, and there is not a God robber among us. How the Bible says, if you don't tithe, say you're robbing God. Not the church, God. And I decree that every blessing that comes to the tither is on you now, in Jesus' name. How you got that? Okay. So we're going to get ready to receive. They're going to come around? Okay. You can direct them greeters, and then I'll pray over the offering. Y'all won't see me for another month. I'll be back in next month.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I know it, huh? That's my baby grandbaby right there. My sweet little grandbaby. It's my sweet grandbaby. I call her Baby Lee. She's my Baby Lily.
Walking around these walls, I thought by now they.
Oh, glory. I don't know about y'all. I don't know if I'm tired of this anointing here today, but it's a great anointing here today. Hallelujah.
Waiting for change to come.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Knowing the battle's won.
Hallelujah.
For you have never.
The Lord God is good. Is that it? Oh, yeah. For those that are on Facebook. Is it still on? Facebook still on? Okay. For you that are on Facebook, there's giving on there right now online. And all you got to do is you can look at the different aspects of areas of giving you can give. And every blessing we've declared in this house, we declare it on you also in Facebook. And how means that you're watching this, Facebook, YouTube, if you're watching it, we declare the same blessing that's on this house today is also on your house in Jesus' name. So God bless you, Facebook. We love you so much. Amen. Praise God. Let's go ahead and pray over this. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just declare supernatural favor, grace, blessing, and increase upon your people. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm going to turn it back in the Alfred and Noel's hands. Is that what I'm going to do?
Yeah.
Okay, good. And I just want to just say to all of y'all that overall, I am very proud of y'all.
Amen.
I am. I really am. Praise God. And it's just good to see how God is moving in your life. But until then, let me present back to you all your pastor and wife, Pastor Al and Noel.
Amen.
I told y'all that word was going to be off the chain.
Amen.
Y'all already know. I should have told us to buckle our seatbelts. That's what we're going to start doing, say buckle your seatbelt, because we was, man, please, about to jump out the seats and carrying on. We're going to be running around here and all that. Amen.
Amen. So go ahead and make sure you look at the announcements that you got. Get the make sure you review the announcements. We'll be posting some more announcements on our church page, IAM Church Online. You can look on Facebook. We'll be posting all the comments, all the announcements, letting everybody know about the October, November, and December, and also New Year's. Man, this year is almost over with you guys. Amen. So go ahead and be prepared to get yourself ready for what's about to go on and get ready for next year. Amen. I'm ready for next year to really launch out. Amen. About to launch out into the deep, amen. Yeah, God's just setting us up. He's developing our. We talk about covenant. He enhanced covenant. We've been talking about faith. He enhanced faith. So now we better just get ready for the overflow, amen. Ready for the overflow, amen. So get yourself ready for what God's doing. And man, like I said, just the way that God's doing with the church here and the ministry here and just the. Just decorations and just everything. I'm just really excited. It's just blowing my mind. You know what I mean? Like, and that's one thing I was telling him also. You mean like I didn't want to get in ministry also with not do. I wanted to do it the way I know I was taught. I didn't want to go work a job and do ministry. I wanted to really totally depend on him. Amen. So when I got into ministry, I did the same thing what I saw him do. Amen. Where I really depended on God to be my source. And so God's been taking care of me and my wife, and you know what I mean? He's been allowing us to still move forward, and I mean, God set up some investments and some things in my life and my wife's life that we can just depend on him only. Depend on him only. We didn't have to worry about working 3 or 4 jobs and still do church and still do ministry. I mean, because everybody know ministry is work. And Lord, you got everybody pulling on you from membership to leadership to pastors to elders to deacons and then still got to study on top of that and still be in prayer on top of that. And I said, I didn't want to be doing all that and still not able to give God my 100%. Amen. So with that being said, I thank you guys for coming into agreement with us and coming to covenant with us to allow me and Pastor Noel to do what God's called us to do. Amen. So we'd like to say thank you guys also on that also. Amen. Got something you want to say?
Just that everybody's amazing. You all are so amazing. You know, I just like to tell you thank you so much for just coming together with us. to help us continue to fulfill the vision that's been given over 40 years ago. It's the same vision and it still works. The word of God still works. It still applies to us. And thank y'all for getting behind this ministry and following the vision, which means we're following God. Amen. Long as we know, y'all know. And so I just want y'all to know how much we appreciate y'all. I might not say it much, but I just want to say it. Just that we appreciate you all because y'all could have, look, y'all could have jumped ship too. And those of you that are newly on board, thank you for being on board and riding the waves with us. Amen. And those that stuck it in there, look at what the Lord is doing, not only in this building. I'm just so excited because God is doing it here in the building, but he's doing it in each and every one of our lives too. Have the storms come? Of course they have. Yeah, I'm not going to pretend like nothing happened. We're not going to pretend like that because that's the facts. But one thing we do know is the God that we serve is going to get his glory out of no matter whatever the storm has been. He's going to get his glory out of it. So, again, I'm sorry. I ain't going to preach. I'm just excited because I'm just full of love today.
Amen.
And I just want y'all really to know how much we really appreciate you. And you all did amazing. We were in church for days at a time last week. And thank y'all for all of your service and everybody did everything. I feel like you all were in kingdom excellence when we had people here that don't come to church, that don't go to church, and you all were in operating in kingdom excellence. And thank you for that. Amen.
And we know what's going to come. We got a lot of text messages from people who don't even go to church here. They was like, from the time we walked in the door until the time we left, we like to say, oh my God, y'all church was this off the chain. I'm like, oh, thank you. They were like, you know, from the greeters to the ushers. They was like, for the people who just loved on us, they was like, we ain't never been to a church like that. They was like, don't worry, but we're going to be coming back. I said, well, you keep on coming back. I be getting messages in my messenger all the time. And I probably got over 100 new Facebook friends who came to the funeral that added to be, and they said, also invite me to your church. So they watch us online now every throughout the week. So that's God. That's God. And that's based on our team that we have here. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you guys. We love you guys for doing what you guys are called to do and just stepping into purpose. Amen. Well, without no further ado, we're going to bring up one of the best assistant pastors in Arizona, Pastor Cedric Gardner. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I received my Rolls Royce too. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Apostle. Bring me into the family. We blood. We in blood covenant here. Praise God. No haters now. Praise God. Praise God. We truly thank our apostle and Ambassador Beverly for coming in once again. Amen. At this time, I'd like to dismiss our apostle and Ambassador Beverly. Please stand. And our visitors, do we have any visitors today? Any visitors? Amen. Thank you, brother, for coming out. Hey, praise God. Praise God. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Amen. I met the brother in the parking lot. He drove up on his two-wheeler. And he said, yeah, look, yeah. He came on in. He told me, he said, Apostle's going to be here. I said, okay. I said, I don't know. I said, I know Junior's going to be here. Praise God. Amen. Thank you for coming, brother. All right. Praise God. You said you're coming back. Amen. You can be dismissed. You can be dismissed. Oh, I'm sorry. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, he is. God has abundant blessing for us. Amen. But the key is to seek him first. Seek God first and his righteousness. Then all things will be added unto us. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for the word that was brought forth. We thank you for the seed that's planted in us, in our hearts and in our spirits, Father, in the name of Jesus. Continue to bless our apostle and Ambassador Beverly, Father. Continue to be a fence around them. Continue to bless them. Continue to bless our pastors and our IAM Church community in the name of Jesus, Father. Now to him that's able to do exceedingly abundantly above more than we ask or think, according to the power that dwelleth in us, through Christ Jesus. Let the church say, amen, and you are dismissed.